Hi, I'm Ruskus Glow, and I'm going to talk you setting up the Broadlink RM Mini 3 and getting it to work with Google Assistant. Some sites have said that you need to set up an app called RM Bridge and have a running on an old Android phone, but there is another way of getting this to work with Assistant without having to do that. It requires no extra hardware or coding. When you first set up the RM Mini, in the manual it tells you to download this app. Now, what I would advise to do is to ignore this app and instead download the Intelligent Home Center, which is also by Broadlink. After downloading, you'll need to set up an account, just using email address and password. Once that's done, you're in the app. You'll have a screen that looks like this, except you won't have any devices set up. Now, what you'll need to do is you'll need to add a new device, which you can either do from the device menu along the bottom or pressing the plus sign at the top. And you'll then be presented with this screen. Now, some people have said that choosing the RM Pro or Pro Plus doesn't always work. And so that's not going to work for us because we want to set up the RM Mini. And a workaround for that is instead going to the universal remotes. So from here we click the RM Mini and we'll be in the setup stage. So from here we click next, and what you do is you'll sign into your Wi-Fi, and what this will do is it'll configure the RM Mini. So it may take a little while. Once that's done, you'll be back to this page with the RM Mini 3 set up. Now, to add a device for the RM Mini 3 to control, you need to click on the RM Mini 3. And then we just add an appliance. Now, these are all the different types of devices that can be controlled with the RM Mini. So for the purpose of this, I'm going to set up a TV. I've already set one up before. Now, what you can do is if you've got lots of different brands, so you can pick one, and what it will do is it will try and make sure your TV's turned off, and this button will appear on your mobile. And the idea behind this is you keep pressing the power until your TV does respond, at which point it knows that it's got the right frequency. So, and you do that for several of the buttons, and that's your remote is configured. If your TV or other appliance isn't in that menu, you can go and click that it's not in that list, and instead of getting the RM Mini to try and control your TV, you can point your TV remote at the RM Mini and press the on off on your remote control. It will then acknowledge that and feed it back to your TV, and then it will get a confirmation to say did this work or not. And so you make your way through until your entire remote is configured. Now, in order to get this working with Google Assistant, we need to set up a scene. So a scene is basically a macro of buttons. You can have multiple appliances within a scene. And what we've got here is we've got one other setup. It's called LG TV Volume Up. So you click Add Appliance, pick the device and what button you want the RM Mini to send. And what this is doing is this is turning the volume up 5 times, and I've put a delay of 0.5 seconds between each of these commands. Just that gives the TV a chance to respond, and then we end up at the right volume that we want. Now what you need to do is you need to open your Google feed and click settings, and from there you click settings again and you'll end up on this page. And you want to scroll down to home control, and they've listed a whole long list of different smart devices. You want to find the Broadlink smart home and sign in using the account that you set up earlier. then what we'll do is we'll recognize all of those scenes you've set up will be set as devices. So now if you were to say OK Google run LVGTV power, it will, in this instance, it will toggle the power either turning it on or off. But I don't want to say I have to say run before any of each of these commands. So what I've done is I've also set up a shortcut. So when I say TV volume up, as far as Google's concerned, I've said run LG TV volume up. And here is what I've said to Google. So TV off, it's one of the other ones that I've set up. So it's toggling the TV power. And also we've got TV volume up, activating the LG TV volume up. So that is the RM Mini 3 working with Google Assistant. So no extra hardware, no extra coding. Thanks for watching.